What's up, fellas? I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill, and today we are going to have a replay with LT-100 Ruski light tank, or however you are calling this vehicle. In my opinion, it used to be the best tier 10 light tank, even though I used to prefer this beauty more than Ruski light, because I don't really like the gun on this vehicle, low penetration and so on. But hey, fellas, I think this tank got overtaken by the super duper Ferrari, by the way, my favorite tank nowadays. And Ruski light is just not that good as it used to be before, because Panhard, super Ferrari, or however you are calling this, right, it's just faster, it can arrive to position way easier, it can give you information where enemies are going, and it's just better vehicle. Plus, on top of that, those wheels is working like a shield. So, you get the point what I'm saying, right? Anyways, this replay is not going to be about the Ferrari, it's going to be about the Ruski light tank. And I just really was feeling like I should explain what is happening with the tier 10 lights. Speaking about those three lights, fellas, Panzerwagen or Panzerflipwagen, however you are calling this, it's trash. There is no doubts, it's just shit. Sheridan can be fun with a derp and with a top and with a 390 alpha damage gun, you have very good accuracy, hip hip hooray, it's not bad, but it's not a typical light, it's more likely supporter. Vaza have derpy gun handling, which is annoying, but you have trollish armor, it can work. AMX in general is good light and you can defend yourself, and those two probably is the best lights. Even though, fellas, compared nowadays Ruski light with this, I would prefer this one because I like autoloaders more. This is more style of me, okay? But today we are going to talk about the Ruski light, and oh boy, yesterday, fellas, I had a very, very good session with this tank. I managed to mark it in Rus server, which I was struggling. Funny thing, everything is depending on a lot of luck, speaking of the lights. If you are getting it, Ensk, Himmelsdorf, and then the other shitty ass maps, it's not going to be very good. But today, yesterday, fellas, we had a lot of fun playing with this vehicle, so I hope you are ready to see the third Mark of Excellence battle. By the way, below the stream, in the first pinned comment, you are going to see the third Mark of Excellence highlight, and maybe you are playing with this tank yourself and everything, you can see a stream highlight in the comment section down below, right? And I think it might be helpful for some people, and also it was extremely good session yesterday. First of all, it was going bad after that, everything flipped and we played like a super duper hyper turbo cyan baboon. So yeah, here you go. Okay, fellas, let's go into the replay immediately, right? Let's go. And fellas, we are back. We are playing in Minsk. Yeah, I know a lot of people hate this map. It's no bueno, it's not very enjoyable, but in my eyes, this map is not that terrible for light tanks. I know it's kind of weird, but there is a key position in the both sides, which is this middle over there, right? This position where you can do some laps, do some circles and try to spot the sniper schnitzels over there. And after that, maybe farm people which is playing over there. In this map, in this kind of situation, it's going to be very, very good game. In my opinion, we are going to get a great score and everything is going to work as we are planning to, right? Anyways, what we are going to do right now, we are, like I said before, in my eyes, there is only one gameplay which is possible in the Minsk map. Obviously, you can take some kind of bushes over there in the end game, but other than that, in the first moment of the battle, you need to do some laps like in Formula 1, right? You just need to spot and try to do your best, and sometimes accidents is happening. My bad, I did not saw that guy and I did not meant to do that on purpose by any means whatsoever. Also, one thing which is definitely worth noticing right here, fellas, is the artist, right? You think this ridgeline is going to save you from the clickers? No, it's not going to be the case. It is just not. So Right there, even though start is kind of boring, we can analyze what is happening in this map and what our team is doing. So, first of all, that's what every single of you needs to do, to pay attention what is happening in the battlefield, right? Because if you would pay attention into the maxi map, we have all our people which is playing around this area, so in the city, right? So what do we need to do? We need to understand this. More likely we are going to get flanked like this, right? And I believe it makes sense. I even said that in the stream. We don't have forces over there and it's no bueno. But I was trying to eliminate that light from the game. And then we are seeing Vazovich is pushing, but I'm trying to use this this line of the wall, or how it's called, to not take one for the team. And right here we are trying to dodge a shot, which we did successfully. And right here, this is the moment when I'm thinking maybe I need to take bushes, but I changed my mind. Why? So even though this progetto is more likely going to take one for the team and it's going to be bad, I decide to risk it for the biscuit. I am brave baboon, and from this position over there I will try to get some side shots. Speaking of the Ruski light, the downside in my opinion of this vehicle, okay, good thing you can hit snapshots, it's insanely good, okay. What is bad thing about this light tank is the penetration of the of your gun. 230 and gold is APs which have only 18 penetration more, right? And it's just simply no bueno. So keep this in mind, and shell velocity is way slower. Anyways, Ruski light is getting spotted right here, being one shotable, and now fellas, we are having quite some problems. How our problems is looking like? We have like 5 guys over there, and our team is trying to push like this, which is not the easiest thing to do. And you know what I'm doing? I am brave baboon. I'm yelling Russia and I'm going in front. I want to support this 3105. Oh my bananas. I thought I'm streaming once again. Black Swan, you are crazy man, I can tell you that. If you are watching this YouTube video, you owe me a big wet kiss, because I shit in my pants just because of you. Anyways, let's continue, fellas. And right here, we are fighting against this Vaza. I know there is no people over there who could shit on me, because majority of them went very aggressively. And right here, the Ruski light armor is working. The Ruski light is doing the things. I'm aiming for a track, and right here, fellas, this is 200 IQ strategy. I'm not going to go for this guy. Actually, I will try to kill him, but unfortunately, hashtag never lucky, I bounced. And now, I know it's way too risky. That Arta have a shot on me, and I am just afraid. So what I'm doing, I'm pretending I am effing up from here, right? I am going like this. Don't play tanks while you are drunk, or maybe do this. Maybe you will play better, you never know. And I'm coming back, right? This guy is not expecting this, and in the face, we are eliminating him from the game. And right now, our strategy is to go back and try to spot those guys which is playing in this corner over there. Because our guys over there, right, they are holding enemies which is playing around this area, and I don't feel the point. Why would I go to kill them? At Arta, and after that maybe Jack Peasley is going to look at me, and then it would be game over. But what we noticed at Arta, which is saying par 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 par, and we eliminated the clicker already, fellas. We have a solid 4200, right? But it's only a start, because we have idea, we have a strategy, and we are trying to spot, right? And this is what Ruski light used to be best at. Ruski light is having very low profile, okay? There is no doubts about that, right? And it used to be one of the fastest tanks, one of the best camo tanks, but now Ferrari overtaken this tank. Ferrari have better camo, Ferrari have even more trollish armor in my opinion, right? So it's just better vehicle, and plus high explosive ammunition, which is mind-blowing 500 alpha damage. But Ruski light is not bad by any means, and for a random games it's working very good. I noticed the Grille which crossed right here, but I'm not afraid of him. I'm still in this area, in this situation, I'm thinking I will go on the Grille, but I will go in the smart way. No, Grille. I will do this in the smart way. Tricking the Grille, mind games. Trying to I was pretending I will go like this and I thought that this grille is going to wait for me, but oh boy, grille did not did that. And now I'm trying to dodge the shot, but oh boy, grille hit us for solid 800 and clueless badger appearing out of nowhere. Badger, I love you. I'm not trying to track him. Why? Because I have the most tracking, I have the most assisting damage, so tracking damage would not go for Mark of Excellence, so I don't need to do this. And remember what did I said about the mind games. Look at this beauty, fellas. I will pretend I will go like this for a Mr. Badger. I'm waiting until he will get unspotted. He's unspotted. So what Badger is doing? Badger is turning for us. What we are doing? We are trying to flank a Badger like this. This is the beauty of the light tanks. You can play with your opponents. You can trick them like nothing, and it's just beautiful part. That's what I love about it so much. And plus, on top of that, Arthas is not. There is a lower chance Arthas is going to shit on you. Anyways, I hit this guy for one time and right there. Look, since I am very very low profile tank, I can play right there pretty much hold down to hit this kind of shot. Oh boys, it's very complicated. It's very hard. And I am trying to figure out what Mr. Badger is going to do. Maybe he is going to make a pressure, or maybe he is waiting right here. And you know what? Mr. Badger is making pressure. No, sir. You are dead. That was your mistake. And you paid the price for your stupidity. So, amazing battle. 8,700 combined in this pretty shitty ass map. And look at this, we had amazing gaming experience, we did everything properly, and this is the moment when RNG is saying enough. What do I mean by saying that? Look at this, Skill is happy already, his Skill is thinking about picking his 8th kill. He is just traveling through the map and there is a one shot object. Okay, low roll, shit happens, it's okay, now I will pick this kill. Well, RNG have a beautiful sides and the bad sides, and not much what you can do about this. By any means, I'm not complaining. Solid 9,000 combined right here in this battle. In my opinion, that was just perfect game and we did everything properly. And we played very, very well. Do I like this Ruski light tank? Fellas, it's not my favorite one, but I can play with it. And yesterday, it was that day when I could do everything what I wanted. And everything was just working like solid banana out of 10. Anyways, that was your daily dose of skill, fellas. One replay, but it was very, very, very good one in my opinion. This is the map where a lot of people are struggling with. Here you go. Maybe it's going to be clearer to in the start of the battle with the light tank to try to play around this area. If some sides is pushing like this, you can even go through this bridge and try to spot the sniper schnitzels over there, but keep that in mind. You can receive shots from over there, and Arta can actually splash you under the bridge. So this is the things to keep in mind. But this game in general, it pumped my blood tiny touch faster, and it was very, very enjoyable for me. Thank you so much for watching. That was your daily dose of skill, and see you tomorrow. Tomorrow is a Sunday. You know, usually we are not having a replay on the Sunday, but I will do exception. You are going to have something. So, see you next time, fellas. Skill is out. Peace.